So it's way worse than we thought. We're trapped, but we're fine. And good news is that Ryder and Mom and the baby were able to get to the mountain and do the field trip. So they're skiing. And while they're doing that, Liam and I are chilling.
He's
really strong, so be careful if you ever hit that. We're chilling, and what we're doing is trying to get someone to come save us. So we are 3 hours north of San Diego with a broken car. All right, you might notice something pretty exciting, and that's that I'm driving a car. This is so cool. Another exciting thing is Christy has grown a beard.
We like to have beards together.
Yeah, so I've gone crazy with the crochet. Here's a cool thing. I'm starting to learn to question everything the doctors say, because they told me that because I had a seizure, the DMV would suspend my license, and I haven't driven for like 4 months. Just had this inkling that maybe that wasn't right, and so I called my buddy who is a sheriff, and he ran my license, and it is not suspended.
I'm a beer fella.
Yeah.
So shocking.
And so I'm driving a car right now. It's super exciting, and we are going on an adventure that I'm really excited about.
A field trip today to go skiing.
Exactly, and snowboarding. What?
Oh.
Yeah, Ryder gets to take ski lessons. Are you excited, Ry Guy?
He's reading.
Oh,
this is his PE class for the day.
Yeah.
Exciting. Inspire Huntsville Charter School. It's cool.
Yeah, they're yeah. Awesome. By the way, I'm having a really good day. You can't tell. This is exciting. I'm functioning better. I know I had a meltdown the other day, and you guys saw that on my channel, but I've really been doing better since. It's like as soon as I put on the prayer beads that I need a prayer, I can feel myself pulling out of the free fall, which is really cool. Alright, well thank you guys. You are the best, and now we're going to go snowboarding, so the next clip should be us doing that. So things have not gone exactly as planned. On the way up the mountain, we had an explosion under the hood of the Geo, and I'm not sure what happened. It appears that it was working a little too hard going up this hill.
Geos don't like mountains.
All of us in the car. They don't like mountains, yeah.
It's pretty much the answer.
Uh-huh, and so.
We broke it last time we went up the mountain.
We did, and last time I overloaded it as well. So, good news is that we are in a parking lot. But look over there. Complete automotive service and U-Haul rentals, which is good, because we're 7 minutes away from being able to ski and snowboard.
We're gonna go.
Which we definitely want to do. Yeah, and so we can probably get a U-Haul and a trailer and put the Geo on the trailer, go the rest of the way to the ski resort, and then drive it home and return it in San Diego. So that would work, right?
Sounds great.
All right, well, it's an adventure. How are you boys doing?
Good.
All right.
Bye.
Aha, there's our problem. So look, that's our problem. That's easy to fix. We just need pliers and some water.
That snowboard shop was super cool and let me borrow some tools.
That was kind of a beast, but this hose right here is now back on. That's the heater core. So definitely coolant. That's supposed to be cooling the engine. Let's start to spew all over the engine. How are you kids doing? Hi, baby.
Hi.
How are you, sweetheart?
Hi.
What do you think of our adventure? Oh, dude, what? A bagel, a muffin? A sandwich?
Cheese
bacon, egg, cheese, bagel?
With our cheese in the box.
Oh, awesome. And water, that's what we need. We're gonna dump that in. And it has cooled down quite a bit. It's not even steamy. Water bottle number two. Okay, we're getting a little steam here. Good. Definitely the car was getting pretty dang hot there at the end when it was running dry. Understandably so. Hopefully we did not warp that head, because I do not want to change the head gasket again. It was such a beast. And I've got the Mustang to work on now. I want to work on that car. Anyway, we'll find out.
See, it got hot enough to like bubble the paint on my awesome valve cover. Bummer! That's when I knew I was in trouble. You can see it's covered in coolant, but all in all, you know, we hooked that back up. We filled this with, I don't know, six bottles of water, so it's topped off. We're gonna let it sit for a second, and we're gonna try starting it up. Stay stoked! All right, now we're gonna see if it starts. You wanna give it a shot? Give a little gas. No. Sounds pretty weak.
I called Kevin for emotional car counseling. He's the best. And we figured out that it has spark because I shocked myself really, really good. Shorting a spark plug wire to the frame. So we have spark and we flooded it, so we have fuel, but we seem to not have compression. It could be just that the battery is too dead, I'm not sure, but I'm gonna return these tools to the pharmacy. Thank you to the Grizzly Cafe because they brought water and goldfish to my family because they could see we were stranded. And now I'm gonna walk over to Wrightwood Automotive. You guys are the bomb. And check it out, people. Snow. We at least found some snow. And they freaking lent me their jump pack to go see if I can clear the flood and get this thing to start, because they're awesome, and apparently this is the best small town ever. So I will find out where I am and tell the internets about you guys, that everyone should come here and spend their money and go to Mountain High Ski Resort, like we're apparently going to try to do. So they don't have U-Hauls, so we actually do have to just get the car. Okay, we got the jump pack hooked up, and in theory, it's on there, so what we're gonna do is try to clear this flood and see if it will start. Well, for everybody's awesomeness, unfortunately, we haven't gotten very far. It keeps turning over, but it just won't start. We have spark and fuel. That could be the timing belt slipped the gear. I don't know. Everyone's being super nice. This super nice couple stopped and helped the family for a little bit. I'm here with my buddy. Who's this?
Liam.
And the shop is super slammed. Like, they're so behind on cars, they just can't fit us in. And obviously, they did everything they could to help us, so I know they really wanted to, but they just can't, and I understand that. They said there's a shop up and around this corner, and the guy has a Jeep that can probably tow our car up to the place. So we're gonna see if they can help us. If we can get this car running, that'd be great. The other thing is, I'm really hoping that Ryder can at least get to snowboarding. He's got that snowboarding lesson and this field trip and all this fun stuff. So we'll see what happens. So it's way worse than we thought. We're trapped, but we're fine. And good news is that Ryder and Mom and the baby were able to get to the mountain and do the field trip. So they're skiing, and while they're doing that, Liam and I are chilling. Whoa, wow, super, he's really strong, so be careful if you ever do that. We're chilling, and what we're doing is trying to get someone to come save us. So we are 3 hours north of San Diego with a broken car. The tow would be about $500, and it's an $1,100 car, so we're not gonna pay $500 to tow it home. What we need is someone to rent a tow dolly and bring it up and then tow us back. I've done that before when it broke last time, so I know it's possible. And I just went Facebook Live. We just asked all of our friends and family for help in San Diego if they have a tow hitch to grab a dolly and come save us. So we'll see if that worked. I hope it did. I suspect it will, because we've been very loved and cared for, and God has provided for all of our needs as they've come up, and continue to strengthen our faith in this. And so we're gonna figure out lunch, right? Yeah, it's lunchtime. So we have food. Let's see what we've got for food. That's an empty lunchbox thing. That's a puzzle. I thought Mommy left us food. Maybe not. Well, we're gonna forage, but if we find food, we'll eat it. All right, the live video worked. We got lots of people volunteering to help, and it really, like, we had 3 or 4 people, like, mobilizing to help. But Chris Dukas is coming up with his truck, and he's gonna save us, which is cool. He has enough seats that can fit our whole family and a truck, and so he's gonna pick up the tow dolly, and we're gonna push the Geo onto it and then bring it home. And since everybody's skiing, and they took all the food with them to cook at the lodge, because we packed lunch, but we were planning on being together, Liam and I had to go forage for food. And while wandering through the forest, we found this place. It's the Grizzly Cafe, and it's really cool. Look at that moose. And Liam ordered a cub meal, because it's the Grizzly Cafe, and a baby grizzly bear is called a cub. Yeah, because healthy grizzly bear cubs know to eat lots of corn dogs to grow up big and strong like their daddies, right? And he's getting fruit with his. I am getting I think it's called a hot mess sandwich, which is totally appropriate for today. The Grizzly Cafe people. By the way, these are the people who brought out goldfish crackers and water. So even though we're on like super limited disability income, I would normally not eat out at all. We're trapped, it's 2:30, it's time to eat, and they were so nice. Honestly, I'm happy to support them. So if you guys ever come here to, where did we say we were?
Grizzly Cafe.
forget what the name of the city is, but wherever, if you ever come here where Mountain High is, I'll put it on the screen. Make sure to come support these guys. Like, give them all your money for good food, because it's awesome. Liam, what did you have on your cub meal? Yummy, yeah. And what did Daddy share any of his food with you? What did I share? Fries and one drop of what? Jalapeno juice. It was on my finger when I gave him a french fry. He didn't like it.
Yeah.
Hey, so I just wanted to share something amazing that just happened. Our server just came up and said, hey, we just want to let you know that the food's on us today. And I was like, what? You didn't have to do that? And they said, dude, you guys are having a rough day. We just wanted to bless you. And I told her a little bit about how big a blessing that is for our family and what we're going through. And so just God is meeting need after need after need. Someone's coming up with a truck to save us right now. Chris Dukas, you are the man. Operation Save the Geo and Save the Henry. Well, God's all over this. He's taking care of our family. I have no doubt that he will continue to do so. And man, this is all good times. So that's kind of the end of our saga right now. I'm sure it'll pick up when Chris gets here and when the kids and the family get back. But we're chilling where it's warm in the Grizzly Cafe. Can you growl like a grizzly bear quietly? So, Roxy at the Grizzly Cafe is the nicest server of all time. Not only did they take care of our meal, but because we've been here for hours, I'm now crocheting. I'm actually making her a beanie, which I'll have to mail here. But look at what she gave Liam. What is that, Liam?
A big hot chocolate.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Okay, why don't you try it? The top is whipped cream with chocolate sprinkles on it. Oh my goodness, that face is awesome. Is it so yummy? Totally, let's get all cinematic about it. Ooh. Oh yeah. There she is, she's so nice. Liam just said, look Dad, the brown moose, and look. Look, it's alive. Do you see it? It's saying, come to the Grizzly Cafe. This place is amazing and filled with amazing people who will be so nice to you. You should tip them all of your money. What's that? It's all done. It's all done saying that. And look, Liam polished off that hot chocolate. Was it yummy?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're so stoked. All right, Liam, where are we?
In the dark.
In the dark, yeah. In the dark, in the geo. Now, the geo doesn't work, but it is housing us from the cold. It's actually pretty warm in here. You know what you're going to get to do?
Yeah. Play a game on the phone.
Play a game on Dad's phone. How cool is that?
It's a really fun game.
It totally is.
And it's funner than the old game.
That's true.
Yeah, and what's the new one called?
I don't know. It's something about trucks. I'll put it on the screen so that if anybody's really interested, they'll know. Daddy is crocheting because yeah, hashtag do you even crochet, bro. I'm making it for our awesome waitress who bought us dinner and was just so cool. Her name is Roxy. She's really cool. So come to the Grizzly Cafe and tip her huge someday. But right now I'm making her a hat as a thank you. And yeah, Chris Dukas is about 30 minutes away. He's got the rescue trailer and he and I will be pushing this geo apparently up a small hill and then onto the trailer. So we're gonna figure that out. And Mommy and Indy and Ryder are all at the ski lodge chilling in the warmth there. So they're good. We're fine. We're going to do fun things in this car until it gets totally dark.
I'm going to play the game.
That's right. This is our savior.
Yay!
Are you excited?
Yay!
Chris Dukas! You're in my YouTube video.
Google took me the most sketchy way possible.
Oh, did it really?
That like windy road.
Oh yeah, no, it takes, that's what blew my head gasket, was going up that windy road.
And it's like, you can't see, there's a cloud.
Yeah, we were in fog and like, yeah, it was awful.
I was wondering about my head gasket at some point.
Right?
Am I gonna blow my head gasket?
Seriously, I hope not.
What's all right, up, bud?
I think what we should do is push the geo up that hill, and that way we can use that hill to roll it down the hill and onto the trailer.
That's logic.
But you might wanna pull more forward just so we have a little bit more.
Yeah.
All right, he's pulling it forward. Ready? There There it is. No, it hit, there's like, you know how you had to push the rocket over? More toward me.
Finally made it to Mountain High in the Geo, sort of. Yeah, so that didn't go great. But here's Christy and the kids. They're alive. There's Mountain High. Hi. Yeah, you guys went skiing. Ryder, how was your first time ever skiing?
It was awesome.
Oh, good. Lesson learned besides...
In 1,000 feet, turn right onto Walnut Street.
Besides, turn your GPS off if you're going to vlog. Lesson two would be, you know, you get what you pay for with the GeoMetro.
Man, it's funny. It's not like bottled waters have that much water, but it's also not like a Geo radiator is very big. You would notice that it's the size of my hand. So we're driving pretty far, which is exciting because Christy doesn't like driving pretty far. And I'm doing the driving. Christy, I need to tighten up your mustache. I brought my crochet hook, so I can do that.
Hopefully I didn't blow the head gasket again. That would suck. The really bad news that we blew the head gasket on the Geo, which took me so long to fix. So that's a real problem. But at least I do know how to fix that, I guess.
Daddy, you had a call. You had a call, Dad?
Yeah, that's what we'll do.
Daddy, you had a call.
Okay, who was it?
I don't know.
Oh yeah, you can't read, sorry. Okay, Roxy at the Grizzly Cafe is the nicest server of all time, and I was a server for a long time. It is? No, it's okay.
It's helping me this weekend with her.
Yeah, so that's exciting.
So thank you.
Sorry.
The
bad news is that there was gas and exhaust in my radiator. All right, a little helper is gone. It's going very well. What? No, honey. That's actually a bad word that you don't know. But don't ever say that, okay? I know you're just making silly sounds, but that's actually a bad word. Oops. Oh dear. He didn't hear that from me. Okay. Anyways, I love you. You're not trouble. Say stay stoked. Or not.
That mustache.
Thank you, Tara.
Yeah, thank you. And then Dina is coming over.
over to relieve Hilda of watching the one at home. And then Val is coming over to relieve Dina.
Thank you, Dina and Val.
And then Delia's going to pick up from Val after Ashton takes his nap. Thanks, Delia. And yeah, she's taking him to her house for dinner and bedtime routine stuff. And then Tara is bringing the two she's had all day back home, and Kelsey's coming over.
Whoa.
And Kelsey is gonna give them baths and put them to bed. And then Delia is bringing the one that she's had for a few hours back home, and Kelsey is gonna put him to bed. And then we will come home.
Wow.
Yeah.
So thank you, everybody. And this is what it takes for our life. And here's how we're so blessed, is that we have tons of people who are willing to just step in and do what they can. And it may not be, oh, I'll watch all six kids for an entire day, but they'll step in and do what they can. And all that adds up to us being able to live our life. So thank you so much for everybody who's bringing us groceries and sending us Amazon gift cards and watching our kids and doing chores. People are helping us. Like,
Caroline and Logan, thank you for last night when I texted you at 11 p.m. saying, hey, we can come over. And can we do any chores while we're there?
Oh, man,
thank
you guys are awesome.
And I know there's...
Thank you, board shop. That place is called The Pharmacy, and it's a board shop in wherever we are near Mountain High. So super props to you guys. You saved the day. And you were super cool about it, by the way, too. So here we are at the Grizzly Cafe. Seriously, if anybody ever comes to Wrightwood, California, come to the Grizzly Cafe. I just told the server our story and leaving a few details out. And she was like, well, I'm a prayer. I'll pray for you. And I was like, actually, I have a page on Facebook. And she was like, oh, good. Can I give you a hug? And she did. Hang on, buddy. Mommy does.